The skyline's still good.
Looks pretty good, just like we left it, don't it?
I ain't seen no sign of nobody being in you.
Neither.
One state south, deep in the North Carolina wilderness, outlaw shiners Mark and Huck reopen their heavily camouflaged still site after 4 months of winter.
We just need to see what we need to fix, just clean things up.
As a mountain man who keeps his distance from civilization, Mark's perennial challenge is how to make money while reducing the exposure that comes with bootlegging.
Guarantee you that'll work.
Turn the water on.
His solution this season? Produce a super high-proof moonshine that will sell for twice the price.
Ready?
We're fixing to find out.
Whew.
Here comes the water.
Well, we got plenty of water, I know that. Get all this little shit out of here. There's some leaves in it. Yeah, I'm feeling good about this year. Come up with a plan to double distill everything. If you run it twice, you get more alcohol out of it. It's smoother. I believe I can make half the liquor and make the same amount of money. I ain't gonna try to make 1,000 gallon this year. If I can make 500, be fine. Yeah, making double the money on it.
Mark's plan relies on double distillation to produce a spirit that's super high proof, yet smooth and easy to sip. The first stage starts with a pod and condenser to run the mash, resulting in liquor around 110 proof. Then they'll redistill that liquor in a second still, consisting of a pot, thump keg, and extra long condenser coil. By carefully controlling temperature and running the second distillation very slowly, they'll avoid the transfer of harsh-tasting fusel oils and terpenoids to the final product. If the plan works, they should end up with a great-tasting liquor at upwards of 170 proof.
We have to build another pot.
Why build one when I've got one?
Let's go look at it.
Let's go.
See what you got.
Right here it is. .50 gallon.
This will work perfect, huh?
I ain't used it in about 2 years. All we'd have to do is just bust that clay out.
Be a lot quicker than building one.
Yeah.
To set up the second stage of their double distillation process,
how hard that clay be bust off it?
They'll repurpose a copper pot from an old still, then rebuild the furnace that surrounds it at their still site.
And we just need to take all these little chunks like that right there with
yeah,
us.
Yeah, we just have to work it back in. That clay furnace holds the heat better than anything you get out of the store this first build of furnace. It'll stand heat better than anything.
Good looking pot.
Mix up a little mud now.
Yeah, this ain't no different than mixing mortar mix, cement, or whatever. Same difference.
That's about right there, Mark. That red clay, you know, you can use it for a lot of stuff. Back in the day, you know, they chinked cracks in their log cabins, fixed their fireplaces, their chimneys with it. But in this case, we're gonna make a moonshine furnace out of it.
We're getting there, ain't we?
A brick furnace surrounds the pot with indirect convective heat, eliminating any direct contact with a flame that could scorch the mash and give the liquor an unpleasant burnt taste.
Well, stuff's drying pretty quick. Keep my hands wet, that way it don't get so tacky.
Pretty good, don't it, Huck?
It looks good to me. Yeah, all we gotta do is get our flake stand in.
Set him down. That darn perfect car, eh? Pretty good.
That looks level.
Yeah.
Now, this flake stand has not got a worm in it. It's a condenser. I can run it a lot faster than it normally would.
Yeah, it'll work.
That's good, ain't it?
Boy.
We're gonna bring in the flake stand for the second pot with a worm in it. We're gonna run it real slow. This purifies it better, makes it real smooth, and be a lot higher proof.
What we need to do now is set our mash in. We'll be in business.
Turn the water on.
So we're gonna go ahead and mash us in one barrel, and it'll be a working while we're getting our other flake stand built, setting the second still up. Yeah, it's our first batch, Huck.
Yep.
I'm just gonna mash in this pure old corn, this old moonshiner recipe. This corn, malt, and sugar. I like it good as any, and that's the goodest thing to start on.
Ready for the malt.
First mash in's always a good feeling. You know you're getting started. You gotta set a barrel up every day for 7 days. And that way we can run every day.
That's the first barrel, ain't it?
We got her set up. Now then, we get all the rest of this stuff set up. We'll be good shape.
Yeah, we about got it whooped, ain't we?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It ain't gonna fit in there. We're gonna have to take this down. I can see right now.
Just rip her out of the ground if it come up. There we go.
Every time you set up a new steel site, you have to dig more, change things around.
The more level ground we can make, the better.
You can bring the same old pot, same everything back in there winter, you know. You still have to do some shoveling and leveling and just the way the ground settles and everything. Just always work around the steel side.
I just have to build a trough now from that into that. That's pretty good, ain't it?
Oh, yeah, but spent a lot of time last year getting the water run in. Everything worked good, worked right. But we're gonna have to modify the bottom end of it so both flakes stand. Get water.
It'd be a pretty neat little waterfall, I think.
I think the water will come in the second flake stand fine, but we ain't got no way to get the water out away from the box. You know, it starts running over, making a mess. We got plenty of buckets.
Let's see.
Yeah, and you this far back in the mountains, it's a long ways out of here to get something, so if there's anything laying around that you can see that'll make it work, you better use it.
I believe this'll work.
We're gonna take this old water trough right here and gonna try to put the water off right over there. That'll keep us out of the mud.
One of the funnest things about being a moonshiner, you get to build something all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Every day you gotta fix something. This solid work around the steel. There's always something to do.
Right about there. Look at that.
Well, I guess I need to turn the water up.
Yeah, let's see that we got everything right.
She's a rolling, ain't she, Huck?
It's a roll.
That's the good, clean, cold water just right out of the mountains. You can drink this water. It's the best water they are to make moonshine with.
Here we go, boy.
Yeah, boy. Working perfect, Huck. Here it comes.
That's gonna work, though, ain't it?
That's working good. I guarantee you there ain't nobody around to have any smoother liquor than we got. Okay, let her rip.
Yeah.
I'm feeling good about this year. Still real early in the season, and we're gonna get started running early, looks like.
All right, Mark, that's good.
Good?
Yeah.
Hey, fire him.
Fire him up.
This year, we're gonna double distill everything. Double distilling it, you get more alcohol out of it. It's smoother, just a whole lot purer. I can make more money and make less liquor, but it'll take two pots to do it. Today, we're gonna run the first batch through the first pot. We're gonna run this liquor pretty fast. Every bit of it's gonna be high-proof liquor. I tell you what we better do, get us a barrel set up to put our liquor in while we wait.
Yeah.
Mark and Huck will need to make several batches of first-run corn liquor until they accumulate about 40 to 50 gallons of moonshine. At that point, they'll have enough liquor to fill their second still for the final distillation.
Starting to run. Yeah, that's a dripping. Cut the heat back just a little bit. Just a little bit. We'll just let the heads run for a while. I'll toss them out and then we'll be ready to go. We're gonna run this first run a little fast. It really don't matter the first run. If it's a little hot, we're gonna put it in the other pot and slow it down. And then, a lot smoother. We get a little drink here, Huck.
Get a little sample there, let's see. It's gonna be hot.
It looks hot. Boy, it's hot. We slow that down that next run, son. That'll burn your eyes right there. Make at least three or four runs, get the barrel full. Then we're gonna put it in this other pot, and we're gonna double distill this.
First bust.
We're gonna make it a whole lot smoother, a lot better drinking liquor. High proof, and we can get a lot more money for it.